फ्रेंड्स, इट्स सच अ प्लेजर टू हैव प्रिंसिपल एडवाइजर टू रक्षा मंत्री डॉक्टर जी सतीश रेड्डी सर. सर, यू हैव डन ग्रेट सर्विस टू द मदरलैंड आर इंडिया सर. प्लीज टेल अस द न्यू रोल विच यू हैव आफ्टर लिविंग द DRDO एंड वेयर यू पुट द DRDO एज ऑफ नाउ, बिकॉज यू वर्क फॉर सो मेनी ईयर्स एज DGDRND सर.
See, firstly, over the years with the research and development activities what have gone in the country, and particularly in the last few years, the type of trust is given to the indigenous systems. Lots of indigenous systems have been developed, many systems. Now, with these new systems coming, which I'll elaborate a little more, we are self-reliant in missiles, radars, sonars, torpedoes, electronic warfare systems, AVAX systems, guns and aircrafts and all that. This is one thing what has been achieved. Now, a lot of new technologies are being developed in the country today. There is a focus on advanced technology systems, innovations, and also bringing in industries in a big way. And as Honorable Prime Minister has given the direction for Atmanirbhar Bharat and make everything in the country and make the most advanced systems and make exports in a big way. So now all our strive is towards reaching that goal and ambition of Honorable Prime Minister. So there have been lots of gaps which are there, have been identified. We are trying to fill those gaps with various industries, academia, R&D organizations, DRDO, all the people are working on it. We are also importing lots of components, subsystems, systems and all that. We are trying to see that they are all being made indigenously in the country through industry. This is another important thing which have been listed out and all that. And then concentrating on new technologies like quantum technology, artificial intelligence, cyberspace, drone-based technologies, anti-drone technologies, laser systems and whatnot and all that, is advanced materials is one of the concentrations, which is paving the way for the exports. Exports are also increasing. Last year, 13,000 crores of worth. There are lots of inquiries coming from very many countries. So the exports are picking up. And as yesterday Honorable Prime Minister said, $5 billion export. The focus should be making the systems which are exportable, which attract the global countries, and export it and fill the, and try to reach the $5 billion export market.
But sir, there are a few critical technologies, like we heard of a balloon which was being busted by US recently. The airship, the high altitude airship, is going to be the next level which the various militaries are trying to achieve, because they say that the ground military base could be taken to the air. So, and that with the invisibility clock, with the meta materials, how the RDO, and you being the principal advisor to the RM, how you perceive those technologies which should be developed in India, and the next level, next war should be fought with those where the altitude is over 65,000 feet, sir?
Firstly, the airborne surveillance is gaining a lot of importance. Lots of systems, whether you talk about drone-based surveillance or aircraft-based surveillance or AVAX systems, are the talk about UAVs and talk about the aerostats and balloons. So a lot of work is going on in the country also in this direction. A lot of work in the drone-based systems is going on. A lot of industries are encouraged. Lots of surveillance equipment. Similarly, you talk about today, you have airborne Netra,
yes,
airborne surveillance systems and warfare systems and AVAX systems. Similarly, you must have heard, yes, DRDO given a news that the Rustum Tung, which is the medium altitude long endurance UAV, has gone through the final developmental trials, and soon that you should be able to complete that and should be able to get into it. And so similarly, various other technologies, as a research organization, development organization, also industry coming up in a big way, lot of developments are going on in this direction in a big way, and lots of technologies which are required in that. I shouldn't be talking about those technologies, then it's not correct in the public. But a lot of work is going on in the many of the advanced technologies in an integrated way with the academia, industry, R&D organizations, encouraging all of them in a big way.
But sir, high altitude airships, are they really a challenge to our Indian military? Can we detect those kind of airships? If not now, then how can we secure our nation from such threats? Because the threat profile change every time other nations, adversaries are moving forward.
I don't want to make anything light or anything. All are important. Technologies are critical. Technological capability exists in the country. You must be knowing, for weather related and other things, Tata Institute of Fundamental Research has been flying at higher altitudes last few decades here in India. High altitude balloons, TAFR has been flying for civil applications last few decades here. So that is the type of a capability exists here in the country. So that is why I don't want to talk about anything specific. All those technologies which are required, capabilities, some exist and some capabilities are being built today.
Sir, you are the man behind India's superpower, ASAT. Tell us, sir, the next level where we move forward after ASAT.
No, there is no any such a program or project to be taken up. It is Honorable Prime Minister's guidance that India should showcase the technological capability to the world. We have shown it, and India doesn't want to get into any of this space warfare, and so there is no further directions to us.
Right. And what about the fifth generation fighter jet? Where it stands as of now, and what kind of capabilities we will be developing for the next generation also?
Today the country has got the complete technological capability to develop fourth generation, fifth generation, 4.5 generation, or even closer to the sixth generation aircraft. Aeronautical Development Agency has the complete capability to develop a fifth generation fighter aircraft today in the country.
Thank you so much for speaking to National Defense.
Thank you
so much.
Thank you.